Midsommar, written and directed by Ari Aster, is arguably more divisive than his 2018 familial horror Hereditary. With its 140-minute runtime and slow pace, viewers familiar with Hollywood's fast-paced, action-packed style may be left a little underwhelmed despite how beautifully this movie is shot. Narratively, the film is a slow build, with the first 20 minutes providing a setup that's rarely explored or even referenced again. Its complex and mildly convoluted series of events serve only as a device to make us care about Danny. Forgetting the setup feels like a missed opportunity from Aster to explore the themes of grief in greater detail, an aspect covered significantly better in Hereditary. The two key themes in this narrative are that of grief as well as navigating complex, toxic relationships. Midsommar explores the theme of relationships far better, centering on the relationship between Danny and her boyfriend Christian. Beginning with Danny in a cold, isolated society, surrounded by lonely streets and muted colours, her detachment is apparent in her first phone call with Christian. The camera is set squarely on her face, without a single cut to him, implying that she's talking to somebody who isn't fully present. Several other conversations are shown in mirrors, which could imply that people aren't really connecting and are only seeing each other's superficial public face. Throughout, Christian is constantly trying to get away from her, even forgetting her birthday and pressuring her to take psychedelics.
Where are you going?
I was just gonna go to that party for 45 minutes, but you just keep sleeping.
In contrast, the unity of the Haga cult provides a sense of connection Danny has been longing for. As she listens to the elder explain how they view life as a cycle, and having recently lost her whole family, the idea of life being a circle of rebirth is attractive, and we see Danny becoming increasingly immersed in the Haga culture, finding a community she craved. Danny's increased indoctrination into the cult is mirrored by her increased immersion into nature. This begins psychedelically when she hallucinates her hands growing grass, and then her feet turning into grass. Over the course of her May Queen rulership, she becomes covered with more and more flowers to the point of absurdity, where by the end, she has almost entirely disappeared into a gown and crown, with bright blossoms symbolising her surrender to nature and this agrarian society. Her new fidelity to the Haga is evident when she picks Christian rather than a Haga to be the ninth sacrifice. As she watches the burning, she experiences pain, but like the Haga, she also experiences joy. She's watching the vestiges of her former life crumble and can't help but smile as she is free to start anew in a community where she can belong. Aster depicts the Haga clan as the precise answer to everything wrong with Danny's life. She's offered complete acceptance and total empathy as they share her pain and joy, operating as one. This all poses the question then, is there a deeper meaning to be explored, or is it all bare carcasses and no substance? Midsommar's simple narrative is elevated by its approach, making the story feel bigger and broader than its confines. The background, set dressing, and artistic renderings provide an added depth, such as each character being represented by a Scandinavian runic symbol stitched on their clothes. The film is constantly playing into and subverting our modern secular aversion to mystical traditions. Religious worship has become increasingly alien to many of us, and we tend to see ritual acts as primitive or potentially barbaric. The fact Midsommar Monsters takes the form of religious Swedes instead of serial killers or fictional horrors speaks volumes about our society's fear and aversion to culture.